as we look towards a more sustainable future, we have global warming, we have a finite source of energy, that being fossil fuels. We need to be wiser and forward thinking about how we're going to create a sustainable energy future. And I think batteries are at the center of that transition. What if we can make a better battery, or a battery that could supplant lithium-ion battery, that could really accelerate the widespread adoption of electric vehicles?
Today's electric vehicles may be able to drive a range of 300 to 400 mile range. With some of these next generation battery technologies, we could envision a future where that might extend to, say, a 1,000 mile range. And we could also start to electrify some of the more challenging transportation modalities, such as heavy duty vehicles, like some of the large trucks on the road, or even the future frontier of electric aviation.
I'm Professor Jeff Sakamoto. I'm in mechanical engineering and material science. I am the director of this EFRC, Energy Frontier Research Center, and its title is MUSIC, which stands for Mechano-chemical Understanding of Solid Ionic Conductors.
My name is Neil Dasgupta. I'm an associate professor in mechanical engineering and material science and engineering, and I lead a research group that works really in the energy space. So we're looking at both lithium-ion batteries, which are the current state of the art, which have really enabled things like portable electronics, but most recently we're really excited about their potential for enabling electric vehicles and electrification of many sectors that could be powered by renewable energy. But also we're looking to the future of battery technology, where we're thinking about what might be beyond lithium-ion.
The question that MUSIC is trying to answer through fundamental research is, what if we can make a better battery? What if we can make a battery that does not combust? It's intrinsically safe. Does this kind of battery enable a new way of manufacturing that can dramatically reduce the complexity and therefore the cost? And the third one is a better battery. Right now, lithium ions are about 700 or 800 watt hours per liter. A different kind of battery could get us, that we're looking at in MUSIC, could get us to like 1300 watt hours. And that better battery is a solid state batteries.
There's three main components to the battery. There's the anode, which is the negative electrode, and there's the cathode, which is the positive electrode. In between the positive and negative electrodes, there's a really important component, which is called the electrolyte. The job of the electrolyte is to basically shuttle the lithium from one side of the battery to the other when you're charging or discharging it. The current state-of-the-art electrolyte in the lithium-ion battery is a liquid, but there's parallel efforts to see if we could replace the liquid electrolyte with a solid. Our center in MUSIC in particular is focusing on a new class of electrolyte material.
It's called the fast ion conducting ceramic. It can conduct lithium ions as fast as a liquid can, or even faster, and at room temperature. So this class of material is enabling this solid-state battery
that could accelerate our ability to commercialize something like a lithium metal anode. This is widely viewed as one of these sort of holy grails in battery research. That's what might help us to realize that vision of a 1,000 mile range vehicle. And so the promise is improved safety, potentially higher energy densities, but there are some important challenges as well. So MUSIC as a center is really trying to address those key challenges of these interfaces, some of these unique mechanical phenomena that emerge, and also looking at the manufacturing science. What is it going to take to scale these up and make it, you know, something that can actually be commercialized? This is a grand challenge in batteries, and it's not going to be solved by one individual alone. Really, it requires this kind of center-level activity. You know, we're really fortunate that DOE is invested in this. They also recognize the importance of understanding these basic science questions that are going to enable things like solid electrolytes, both for batteries, as well as other technologies will benefit from this as well, such as hydrogen fuel cells. So, you know, I feel very fortunate to be able to work with all of our co-PIs and our partner institutions. For example, in Oak Ridge National Lab, our national lab partner, they have very unique facilities for electron microscopy and neutron analysis that enable us to perform cutting edge research.
So there's some really amazing capabilities at the Department of Energy National Laboratories. Really good science, really good opportunities for collaboration, really good environment for students to work with, you know, shoulder to shoulder with internationally acclaimed, recognized scientists.
Now, having this team across the country that brings together the thought leaders in mechanochemistry for solid electrolytes is really a very unique opportunity. You know, we're very grateful to the DOE to have provided the funding for that. And I think that, you know, we're very proud of how we're executing on that vision. And really, we're just getting started.
It's been said that we are in a battery moment in civilization. And I think that's very true. So I think that the work that we're doing right now is very important on batteries to enable and accelerate the adoption of electric vehicles. And just the overall help with the overall transition from a fossil fuel future, limited future, to a more sustainable electric future.